Hey guys, Devin here from American Aquarium. Welcome to the new video. Thanks for tuning in. I'm revisiting a topic that I've been talking about a few times in the last few months because it's actually a very popular thing that people seem to actually not know about. For that reason, I want to just bring more awareness to it, that it's a super important thing for both freshwater and saltwater tanks, and that's electrolytes. People do not think of their aquariums like a car battery, like they need to balance the charge in their tank, almost like an alternator on a car would charge a car battery. So for that reason, and because of the experience of thousands of tanks and how we saw electrolytes improve fish health long term, balancing these ionic charges for both freshwater and saltwater gave us the best long-term health for fish, hands down. And so when we're maintaining all these aquariums, and our goal, and we have to keep these fish alive to stay in business, the best thing for us to do is find out what worked and what didn't work. So you guys have heard me talk about redox balance and how we get the oxidizers reduced level. I'm going to step back just a little bit and talk about this in a little more layman's terms. Electrolytes, your calcium, magnesium, potassium, and other trace elements that actually hold either a positive or negative charge. It's the difference between water that runs over rocks, say in a stream or in a river to an ocean, versus a closed box aquarium where we don't have that effect and that electrical charge gets depleted. And there's really no way to know unless you have a fancy meter or we understand that these things wear away and that we need to be replenishing them. So best of what we found on our maintenance route with maintaining hundreds of aquariums is a constant supply of these electrolytes. It's like a constant water change. A lot of people think that they can get away with just replenishing their water with a water change, and that would be the number one argument of why they're not dosing these electrolyte minerals. I do water maintenance, so therefore I don't have to. Yeah, but then how do you know for sure that your water actually had electrolytes to begin with? So best is to actually make sure that you're dosing them so that we can say guarantee that we have them. And then also measure to see that, okay, yes, we got the mineral. These are your GH minerals, your calcium, potassium, magnesium. We dose and we can see the mineral and then we know we're getting the electrical charge. And we got to not get confused by that by thinking that just because the minerals in the tank we're getting the electrical charge, because minerals can lose their electrical charge, so then therefore you're still seeing it on a test, but you're not having electrical charge. If you are fortunate enough to have an ORP meter, electromagnetism meter, something along those lines, redox meter, you would be able to read the electrical current in your aquarium and see the effects of when you dose. So best is a constant supply. AAP recommends the AAP Wonder Shell for the fact that it's an easy dose. You throw it in the aquarium, and over time it slowly dissolves, slowly leaching those electrolytes into the tank, keeping a constant charge, very much like an alternator, very much like a constant water change, a flowing river. Other ways to do this is just dosing the minerals in the tank during a water change. While it's not as good as a constant water change, at least you have the peace of mind of knowing that you still are getting those minerals in your tank, and then you're replenishing them each water change. Or what you could do, and along the similar lines of the dissolving block, is say do a slow drip release. So you have a little bit of your electrolytes dripping into your aquarium all day, every day, and then you know you're getting a constant flow of them. So right here I have a handful of products that are electrolyte delivering conditioners for your aquarium. These are some popular ones. A lot of people will know Replenish or C-Chem Trace. That's very similar, even though we recommend Replenish. You could do that as a drip. I even want to say, hey, look guys, a Powerade zero calorie is very much along the lines of what we're talking about, and in an emergency situation could be used. While I'm saying it's best to, and it's best for prevention to constantly dose these, if you are having a sick fish, I would start with, hey, are you giving them electrolytes? You know, when we're sick as humans, we want our electrolytes too. But the thing is you want to make sure that you're not getting anything with sugar. That's where the zero cal comes in. Yeah, there's a little bit of sugar, but it's way down on the ingredient list. All the way at the bottom is sucrose, not the first or second ingredient as sugar. And that is going to deliver some magnesium, potassium, calcium, very important. In a saltwater tank, this might seem like common sense to you guys, and so you go, why is he talking to us like this? I mean, this is kind of like something we're already doing. Well, there is a whole nother layer of ionically balancing your minerals with the sodium, because the sodium is constantly trying to drive out these minerals, and you're getting a false reading on your sodium, and so you're actually building up sodium. You're not having as much minerals as you think you're getting, and therefore your ionic balance, what should be very similar to the ocean water, is actually slowly over time getting out of whack, and you don't even know it. So this applies just as much and is just as important in a saltwater aquarium as well. So I'm going to link you guys some resources to take a look at. If you want to look at some other videos, take a look at my redox where I even get to this even more. I showed some experiments explaining this. But guys, when it came to health prevention, the minerals, electrolyte minerals, were a huge aspect in disease prevention. So we heavily promote this. I want you guys to take a look, and I suggest that you also start dosing these into your aquarium as a constant long-term solution to help boost immunity in fish. You have to have these minerals as they're essential for osmoregulation. So check it out, guys. Oh, and always, thank you. I appreciate you guys' support of our company, getting this professional information out to the hobby. So thank you, thank you, thank you. Bye.